Krishna. This is the story of Sri Leela Shoka, as told by Sri Sri Premi Anna in Vaishnava Samhita. There once was a Brahmana who lived on the banks of River Krishna. He was a very learned person, well versed in the Vedas, controlled his feelings, like anger, and was very calm and compassionate. He dove into the difference of Atma and Anatma in his studies. He lived with his wife and was a big devotee of Lord Krishna and read Srimad Bhagavatam regularly. Since I have referred to this big bhakta as a Brahmana, here is his name, Sri Leela Shoka. His actual name is Bilva Mangala, but he is now famous as Sri Leela Shoka. His guru, Sri Somagiri, taught him a mantra to pray to Krishna called Krishna Chintamani. Having a strong desire to see Sri Krishna, Leela Shoka went all the way to Vrindavan hoping to see him. All the way along, he recited shlokas about Sri Krishna. As Leela Shoka lived very far from Vrindavan, he grew old and blind by the time he reached Vrindavan. Soon he was using a walking stick. His bhakti was so strong that he continued his journey without turning back. Closer to Vrindavan now, Leela Shoka was calling out for Krishna. Lord of the gopis, Keshava, where are you? When Leela Shoka reached Vrindavan, the poor blind man was about to fall into a pit. A boy who was nearby yelled, "Stop! Stop!" The boy was a cowherd, and he gently held the end of Leela Shuka's stick and led him away from the pit. As a thank you, Leela Shuka said, "Young child, may you live long. I have been saved by you. Who are you? Why are you in this forest?" The young boy responded, "My name is Mandakumara. I live in Vrindavan. I'm a cowherd and happen to see you here." Bilva Mangala thought that Nandakumara was Lord Shyama Sundara himself and said, "I think you are Sri Krishna. Can you give me darshan so I can see you?" Nandakumara explained to Leela Shuka that he was just a cowherd and not Bhagavan. Even then, Leela Shuka was not convinced and thought the boy was so sweet and clever. Leela Shuka then held the boy's hand. Then Nandakumara wriggled his hand and started running away. Hearing the tinkles of his anklets, he called him, "Oh Krishna, you ran away from my hands, but can you really escape from my heart?" At that moment, Lord Krishna, who was indeed Nandakumara, saw that Leela Shuka was a great devotee and blessed him with a special vision so that he could get Krishna's darshan in his mind. Neela megha shyamalancha bahi barhavatam sakam Navanitam kare dhritva natantam nandanandanam digambaram diva bandum shardulam matha nakhabhushitam kinkini kati sutradi nana mandana manditam kapatasmera vadanam kajjalalipta lochanam Padalankritam Manjiram Gopalam Bhaktavatsalam. Krishna looked beautiful. He appeared as Nandakumara, a small boy with a ball of butter in his hand, dancing. He had various ornaments on, like a tiger claw necklace, a katistura, which is a waistband with bells on them, kajal on his charming eyes, and best of all, his naughty smile. Taking the darshan, Leela Shuka, crying, fell at Lord Krishna's beloved feet. Leela Shuka continued to live in Vrindavan with his wife and later wrote Krishna Karnamritam. It is a very sweet set of stotras describing Krishna Leelas, so he became famous as Leela Shuka. Radhe Krishna.